Good afternoon, everyone. On behalf of our parish family, I would like to express my condolences and our support in prayer today to all of you. And I thank you all for being here today to celebrate Marion's life. So before we begin this celebration of life, I invite Jeff and Gina to come and share with us their memories.
Good morning, everyone. What a great showing of love and affection for, I guess I could classify her as the world's greatest mother. She wore many hats, a daughter, a sister, a wife, a mother, a grandmother, a secretary in charge of food and entertainment for the family business. She did it all. She was a very wonderful person that touched a lot of lives. It didn't matter if you were friends of the family or a friend of a friend of a friend of the family. She was there 7 days a week, 365 days of the year. She led us through some tough times. Knew that she had her family when things got rough. She was just a wonderful person. I could sit here for hours and tell you the wonderful things about her, and we could talk about the bad things, but I don't remember any bad things that come to mind. She'll be missed. She's missed already. The house is pretty quiet without her. I haven't eaten really good food in the last 8 days, for sure. The wonderful thing that she was able to do is she was able to put a smile on your face, whether it was through her cooking or through just simple conversation that she had. You know, she was given that gift of a smile that would bring any kind of comfort to anybody that wasn't really having a good day. She'll be missed. She'll be missed. I can't say that more than anything. I'm grateful for the life she lived. I believe we're blessed for the love she gave, and we'll miss her dearly. Thank you, everyone, for coming today.
Hi, everyone. I'm Gina, Grandma's fifth grandchild. I'd like to start out today by extending a sincere thank you to all of you for coming to celebrate my grandma today. My whole family has felt an overwhelming amount of love and care from each of you during this time, and we couldn't be more thankful. Grandma always said it's important to have a lot of friends. We knew she was a popular gal, but seeing all of you gather today and seeing so many different faces, it really put her popularity into a whole new perspective. When I sat down to figure out what I wanted to say that best described what my grandma meant to me, I started by listing my favorite qualities and memories with her. As I continued to write, my list continued to grow until I realized that list is going to be infinite. Growing up, I liked to write my grandma letters and leave them on her desk. So I wrote her one final letter, and I'd like to include you all as I read it to her today. Hey, Grandma. I wish you could be here today to see all the lives you touched that are here to honor and celebrate you. You would feel so loved. You had such a special way of bringing people from all walks of life together and making them feel special and welcome. We all wish we had more time with you, but the time we were blessed to have was filled with so much love. I want you to know that because you built our family around so much love, that we'll be okay down here. We'll continue to care for each other just like you taught us. I'm filled with so much joy knowing that you've moved into heaven and will spend an eternity filled with just as much love and happiness as you gave down here. You're finally pain-free. You won't have to worry about that pesky arthritis in your shoulder. Your vision will be crystal clear, and you can finally say goodbye to your walker. All your hair days will be good ones. Your nails will remain perfectly manicured and unchipped. Your lipstick will not fade, and you'll be styling in the most beautiful clothes. I imagine God will give you the keys to your car so you can take your leisurely joyrides like you used to love. The cooking shows will not have commercials, and the chairs will not hurt your bum. The kitchens will be stocked with the finest appliances and tools. You'll finally have those sharp knives you've been wishing for. All the ingredients will be fresh and pure to enhance your dishes. I have a feeling God is going to put you to work on some homemade spaghetti after seeing so many different people rave about it over the years. He's going to love it. I think you should serve him some of your homemade pretzel tort for dessert. I bet heaven has the most beautiful orchids. Pick the prettiest one and think of us whenever you water it with your ice cubes. It's the best people in life that make goodbyes so hard. I'll never stop missing you, but I find comfort in knowing that you're doing just fine. Holidays and birthdays will be especially tough, as you always made a point to make our whole family feel special on them. I'll miss getting two different cards on my birthday, one heartfelt and one silly one that sings. Since my birthday is coming up next, I'd like to ask for one last wish, if you don't mind. Please give Jenna wisdom as she makes her way through college. Be there with her while she takes her tests and remind her to continue making a lot of different friends. Remind Tony that he's shaping up to be a great electrician. His knowledge and understanding of the trade is much like John and Jeff's, and you're very proud of the young man he has become. Please help Alex as she navigates her way through life. Be there with her as she pursues her passion to become an esthetician, and remind her that there's no test she can't tackle. Guide Lauren as she continues to find joy in substitute teaching. Help her to pass on your kind ways to young kids and keep her strong on the tougher days. Remind Gabby that she's doing just fine in life. Please help to keep her happy, even on days when the law firm is hectic. Please comfort Mitchell in the office. Do your best to show her that you're still there with her. Help her laugh and find joy, even though it will be different at first. Remind her that you're watching down on her. Please watch over Rosalie and Ty as they begin their life together. Remind them that you will be in their hearts on their wedding day and that you'll be watching from the best seat in the house. Remind Auntie Jody and Uncle Brian to try new food places, experience new things, and explore the world just like you did. Help to encourage them to take that vacation you've been telling them to take. Please watch over Uncle Jeff. Guide him to keep the kitchen working and fill the house with aromas of new meals. Help him to keep exploring the world, trying new foods and experiences just as you did. Please be with my mom and dad as they make new recipes and grow old together. Please give my dad strength. And watch over him to help him win this battle. Please help him to find joy just as easily as you did, even in the toughest of times. During my final goodbye to you, I thanked you for being my hero. I can't help but think of how great of an honor it is to now have you watching as an angel over my family and I. When I see happiness in them, I'll know you're making my wishes come true. In closing, thank you one final time for being such a special light in my life. I'll think of you on sunny days. I'll know you're there when I see a butterfly flutter around. And I'll continue to feel your love whenever our family gathers together. Thank you for this life, Grandma. I'll celebrate the woman you were today and every day. Please give both my grandpas a hug from me. I love you forever and a day. Until we meet again, all my love, Gina.
Welcome to Holy Apostles Parish. Today is a time of grieving, but also a time to praise God for the life of Marion Jrolf, to send her back to God in thanksgiving and gratitude. We invite you to support the family and each other by participating in our prayer and song in the glory of the resurrection. All the music for today's liturgy will be found on the video screens. Our opening song is Be Not Afraid. Please stand.
Let us continue this celebration of life in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father and our Lord Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, our sister Marianne died with Christ and rose with him to new life. She may now share with him in his eternal resurrection. We now place the resurrection pall, remembering our day of baptism. The children are coming too. Let us pray. God of loving kindness, listen favorably to our prayers. Strengthen our belief that your Son has risen from the dead, and our hope that your servant, our sister, Marianne, will also rise again. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated, and I invite Rosalie to proclaim the first reading.
Reading from the Book of Wisdom. The just man, though he die early, shall be at rest. For the age that is honorable comes not with the passing of time, nor can it be measured in terms of years. Rather, understanding is the hoary crown for men in an unsullied life, the attainment of old age. He who pleased God was loved. He who lived among sinners was transported. Snatched away, lest wickedness pervert his mind or deceit beguile his soul. For the witchery of paltry things obscures what is right, and the whirl of desire transforms the innocent mind. Having become perfect in a short while, he reached the fullness of a long career. For his soul was pleasing to the Lord. Therefore he sped him out and in the midst of wickedness. But the people saw and did not understand, nor did they take this into account. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond.
I invite Mitchell to proclaim the second reading.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, those who are led by the Spirit of God are the sons of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you received a spirit of adoption, through which we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit itself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God, and if children, then heirs. Heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ, if only we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him. I consider that the sufferings of this present time are as nothing compared to the glory to be revealed for us. For creation awaits with eager expectation the revelation of the children of God, for creation was made subject to futility, not of its own accord, but because of the one who subjected it, in hope that creation itself would be set free from slavery to corruption and share the glorious freedom of the children of God. We know that all creation is groaning in labor pains even until now. And not only that, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, we also groan within ourselves as we wait for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain. After he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of my name. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Jeff and Gina, for sharing your wonderful memories of your grandma, mom. And thank you for giving her the title, the best mom and grandma in the world. So today, as we gather to celebrate 93 years of gift of life, a precious gift of life in the person of Marion. Am I saying your name right? Marion? Marion? We, as people of faith, we draw inspiration from our sacred scripture that really teaches us and tells us that life that all of us have is a divine gift bestowed upon us by God, who is known, who is defined as love. So God is love, and if we, all of us here, are created by this God who is love, so we do become, the essence of who we are all is nothing but love. And our life here on earth comes with a mission and a purpose. And people of faith have told us and taught us that that mission and calling revolve around being the loving reflection of God to this universe, to the world that we are part of. So how do we do that? And as some are kind of naturally gifted, and the way they relate with the people, the way they relate with the world, it is just so very loving. And when you are in their presence, you feel loved by them. You feel special. And we know Marion was someone, if you are in her presence, you feel special, you feel loved, because she had such a big heart. She will, give to you. She will make you special. She will be present to you. She will cook for you, of course. She will bake for you, and she will take you to shopping and all of that. So we celebrate someone's life today who all of you have come to know her, loved you very much. And when you were in her presence, you knew that this person has a big heart for you. This person was very inclusive of you. This person had time for you to listen to your stories. And that is who we are celebrating today. And of course, God does not just randomly create us, but he has given us a mission to fulfill here on earth. And God himself took a human flesh in the person of Jesus to show us that how we can embody this reflection of love here on earth. And the best way that our Lord Jesus showed us was like when we learn to be sacrificial, when we learn to give wholeheartedly ourselves to others, we really bring meaning to life. Not only we make life beautiful and joyful for us, for our family, but for the rest of, you know, all the people around us. And Marion was gifted to do that. And look at her lifestyle, that whether it was just a special events, she was a gifted person to host. It was not just about partying, but it was about bringing people together to connect, to bond, and to share what you have with one another. That was just so beautiful. I think that is something that is living, she's living behind us to follow, to emulate, so that we can bring joy and fulfillment in our lives and for the people around us. And so as we celebrate our life, we remember all of that. And when we are sad, especially when we grieve the loss of our loved one, you look around us, even you look at up the sky, the clouds, you know, they kind of reflect our sadness, our sorrow. Even the plants, the trees, you look around, and not only the people that has come to celebrate and grieve the loss of your mom and grandma, but everything around us, the whole nature, kind of reflects what we are going through. But that's where the Word of God comes to us, giving us a new sense of hope that this is not an end to our mom, grandma, our sister, and friend, but a new beginning, a hope that her spirit is going home to be with God. because God is our home. God is our origin, our source of all we are. And that is our hope, that one day we, all of us, will get to join her and celebrate for the rest of our life, for, you know, infinite, for endless, eternally, we will also join her celebrating divine life that we have right now here, that we, through baptism, for people of faith, the moment that we are baptized, we enter into that divine union with God that matures, that attains its fullness as we leave our body and our spirit joins home with God. So that's what we are here to celebrate today. And from the scripture that we celebrated for her life, speaks to us about it. The Book of Wisdom says that he who pleased God indeed was loved. Indeed, we know that, how much she was loved. All the people that have come to know her, I believe that you loved her, because you cannot help but love her and to open your heart to her presence that touched your lives, that made a difference in your lives. And so she indeed, through her acts of kindness, through cooking and all of that stuff, that she loved, she pleased God. And that's what comforts us today, to know that in the sight of the Lord, she pleased God by her way of life, by her style of life. And we take comfort in knowing that. And St. Paul kind of encourages us to, that we are not just body, we are also spirit. And through spirit, we connect with God. And through spirit, we live in a way, the divine essence that God has given us, because God has fashioned us in his own image and likeness. And so we are nothing other than God himself. Because as saints would say that God does not have a body, that's why God created us, to be his body, to be his face, to be his feet and hands on earth, so that we can be a loving reflection of God. And Marion, in so many different ways, she reflected that love of God through her life. And in the gospel, our Lord Jesus says in the Beatitudes, the essence of life, where one can find happiness and joy, is not in having a lot of wealth, a lot of power and control, but it is in the essence of, in the attitude of, like, having, being a peacemaker, having mercy for others, and having a pure of heart. Those who have pure of heart are children of God. They can see God. Those who are merciful, they will be given mercy. They will be shown mercy. And that's what Jesus teaches us, where one can find happiness and joy in life. And we know that our sister embraced those attitudes to be our way of life. And all of us here who have gathered to celebrate our life, I think we can follow her example and find happiness, and also share generously that happiness of life, that joy of life comes by being ready to sacrifice, being selfless, because she kind of excelled in love of neighbor, because she always opened her door for people to come in and have food in abundance. So we remember that, and we celebrate that, and we take comfort in that as we continue to celebrate our life here. I invite Gabby, Lauren, Gina, Alex, Tony, and Jenna to come and lead us in prayer. Please stand.
Lord, you raise the dead to life. Welcome our sister Marion into your loving embrace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for the family and friends of Marion, that they may be comforted in their grief, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the strengthening of faith, hope, and charity in all the virtues in those here present, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end of hatred, violence, and war, the renewed commitment to forgiveness, healing, peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us who are gathered here in faith, that we may be gathered together with all of our loved ones once again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our deceased relatives and friends, that they may share communion with God in heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers we offer for our sister and all those who have gone before us. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them the place in your kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated, and I invite Sherry, Brian, and Ty to bring the gifts to the altar. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands
for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and good of all God's holy Church. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant, Marianne, may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jerome, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Marion, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Pugaro marchium, yendrendrum omaku, orea de.
Let us now pray as our Lord Jesus Christ taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us now offer each other the sign of peace. Behold our Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word,
and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Marion, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, trusting in God, we have prayed together for our sister. And now we come to the last farewell. May our farewell express our affection for her, and may it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Marianne in the hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon her in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowships with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I'd like to thank our Resurrection Choir for helping us to celebrate Marianne's life, and thank you. And the family would like to invite all of you to share table fellowship after Mass in the Welcome Center, right on the left side. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
In peace, let us now take our sister to the place of her rest.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Dave. Life is good. Yeah. We have funeral tomorrow also. Yeah. This evening we have Chrism Mass, you know that? Chrism Mass in the Cathedral Church.